Baked, are you here?
Yo, what's going on, dude?
What's up, brother? How's it going?
Good, yeah. Sorry a little bit. I'm just calling in quickly here.
That's cool.
I'm in the car on the way to go camping. We're actually doing a camping stream on LOULZ's stream tonight in about an hour here. So
sick.
We're going to be chilling with the bros, Ada Wolf's out here, my homie. We're going to be roasting some marshmallows, hanging out, and might make a little trip to Miami again and maybe snipe Foozy or something. So, yeah, man, it's good to be back doing IRL. I've been loving it, but, yeah, thanks for having me on.
Yeah, man, I appreciate you coming in. And, yeah, we'll probably show some of that towards the end of the show, and then maybe we can direct some people over there, too, when I wrap up at 10. And I'd heard about that. LOULZ had mentioned that y'all were doing a camping thing. I didn't know the whole – now, what do you have planned for this?
Yeah, so it's we don't have that much planned other than, like, we're just trying to do more, I guess, like, you know, adventure-type stuff, you know, like immersive experience where you're, like, hanging out with us by a campfire. I don't know. We just thought that would be cool. We found a cool cabin – location near Miami, so yeah, we're just gonna check it out. If it, you know, hopefully it's cool, and then we're gonna probably hit Miami later. So you know, it just feels really good to be done with jail, done with all my time, you know, finally the shackles are off. You know, I still got that probation, but that should be off hopefully by the end of the month. So you know, we're doing all that. But I do gotta say, Ralph, oh my gosh, your show has been hilarious today. Absolutely loving it. And it's crazy that the casino is seizing so hard, and they're trying to tell us, like, hey, you should dox your employees and, like, give us a roster list of everyone who works for you. It's like, you don't even use our service. Like, isn't it funny, Ralph? All the people that don't use PowerChat have all these demands for us. It's like, you guys don't even use PowerChat. Like, why do you have all these
well,
a roster of every developer that works? It's like, it's not that deep, man. There's no weird conspiracy. We just have normal fucking dudes that don't give a fuck about politics that write code for us. That's it.
Well, and the thing is, I mean, it's so transparent, Baked, what they're doing, right? That it's not even, it's not subtle.
Yeah.
It's not subtle at all. Like, there is a way to do this kind of attack and be a little more subtle about it and not just be so, you know, blatantly see through with what they're doing. You know what I mean? Like, they immediately turn what they were doing last night into an attack on me and you, and, you know, trying to drag us down and making up all this bullshit. Like, it's so obvious.
And we were all being nice. Like, let me be clear. I was chilling with Ada Wolf. We were playing Diablo 4, and, you know, I had some different streams on, and I had Casino on, and I said in their chat, Casino always wins, just kind of like, you know, having some fun, and they're like, oh shit, Bakes in the chat. And then I gifted them a sub. They're like, oh shit. And then I gifted them 20 subs. I was feeling a little generous. And here's the thing, I do give them credit. You know, they were correct early on about Nick and America First and, you know, some of those similar topics. But I think, like, me and you have given them credit. Like, we're not saying, like,
I said that too.
We, you know, yeah. So it's like, I put out the olive branch, I threw them some subs, and they were like, oh my gosh, Big, we love you, and we want to make music with you. And I was like, okay, sounds cool. Like, sound good to me. And then, like, an hour later, they're back to, like, lying about me, trashing me, ambushing LOULZ, my good friend, you know, trashing my company. It's like, oh, okay, I see what they're really about then. You know, I thought, you know, listen, me and Andy have both done some fucked up things to each other. You know, we said some, we've thrown some barbs here and there, but it's like, at the end of the day, that was so long ago, I don't even remember half of the shit. And I thought it would be funny, like, I'm not trying to be the dude's best friend, but, like, yeah, hey, let's, you know, make a parody song together, making fun of Feaser or making fun of Nick. Like, that sounds like it would be great for content. It would be great for the sector. Everyone would, it would just be funny. And I'm all about whatever's the most funny. But then they just, like, took that and, like, spat in my face. And, like, it's like, okay, dudes, I tried. Like, I tried to be cool, whatever. I mean, Worski followed me. I don't know if he's going to, you know, unfollow or block me. I don't know. But, you know, I'm trying to keep it chill. I don't know what their issue is. But it's like, all of a sudden, they just heel turned and started, like, seething about PowerChat when they weren't even talking about that. And it's like, all eyes are on Nick Fuentes. we're literally in front of 40,000 live viewers. Sneeko got pressed about his association with Nick Fuentes and Ollie Alexander, the pedophile, and how America First sweeps that up. That should be celebrated. And what did these guys do? They took that opportunity to attack us. So everyone listening out there, I don't care if you hate me. I don't care if you fucking hate Ralph. I don't care if you hate LOULZ. I don't care who you like or who you hate. But if you can recognize that there's a fundamental problem with America First and the shit, the pedophile shit Nick Fuentes is pushing, then you should at least be with us on this point. I'm not saying you need to agree with us on everything, but on this single point, I think now they're just, you know, the casino is getting in the way of, you know, some productive things that are happening towards this goal.
I couldn't agree more. And I even said, you know what? They were right long before I was. They did do some good work exposing a lot of this AF stuff. And, you know, some of that stuff still holds up. But it's like you said, you don't have to be our best buddies. You don't have to, you know, promote us or, you know, for whatever, you know what I mean? Like, become our super allies. But when you're actively detracting from the assault on America First, then you become a hindrance and not a help. And, you know, they've been doing this for several weeks, and I've kind of, like, mostly ignored it. I wasn't ignoring it today. Back up over 1,200 live here on the Killstream on all platforms. And, you know, to be honest, I think a lot of it is they're threatened by the Killstream rising, by other people rising, and you coming back on the scene. And they don't really, you know, they're trying to protect their territory like a fucking corner stop drug dealer would do or some shit. Right? Yeah. But it's the scarcity mentality. Like, they think there's just a limited amount of funds. There's a limited amount. When really, I mean, I guess at a certain point it's limited, but, like, I feel like most people, and I've seen this on Twitter from allies and foes alike, would actually like us to kind of unite on this, maybe even do some shows together.
Yeah.
They come on my show, I go on their show.
Exactly.
Let's you know, have it that way. But they're hesitant to do that.
They don't.
They
don't want to play like that. You know, and at the end of the day, it's like, look at what they're talking about. They're talking about money. PBP is literally crying that he spent $100 on two pizzas. It's like, bro, it's $100. Like, first of all, how are you eating that much pizza? Like, put down the pizza box, boy. And second of all, like, $100, like, you're spending $100 a day on food? Like, damn, man. Like, are we feeding cattle out here? Like, you know, what's going on? And that's a lot of food. You know what I'm saying?
It's brutal. And apparently he wanted three pizzas. Like, that's what people in chat who saw the show said. He actually wanted three pizzas.
He was still hungry.
Yeah, three pizzas, big.
Two, and these were, you know, $50 pizzas apparently. So two extra large pizzas, that wasn't enough. You need a third one plus the breadsticks, the soda. I mean, listen, I'm saying this honestly. PBP, come home, white man. We need to get you on a diet. We need to do the Biggest Loser. Let's do a weight loss challenge. Bro, you're going to die. And I'm not saying that maliciously. I'm saying that as a dude who's been overweight. Not as overweight as you, but you are literally at risk to fall over and die at any second. And that's, like I said, not an attack. That's just the truth.
And I said that earlier, and of course, you know, I went off on him, and, you know, we've had some laughs. I'm taking some shots. But literally when I say that, he's in a danger zone here, and it's not getting any better, dude. It's getting worse.
Yeah.
And I did this impersonation earlier, and people may think I was being over the top, but not really. Like, when he gets up out of his chair, like, he actually has to, like, gather some forward momentum, or he can't get up, baked. Like, it's that bad, dude.
Well, that's not good.
It's not good.
Yeah, that's not good. Plus, it puts, you know, all this weight on your joints, on your knees, on your, you know, on your organs internally. I mean, as you know, it's fucking terrible. And listen, I'm not saying I got a six pack over here, but at least I'm working out, I'm dieting. You know, I showed you I lost like 6.5 pounds since I got out of county jail, YoFit. And also, like, I'm inspiring, me and you have been inspiring each other, big tech, you know, people in our community, you know, we find joy in that. That's like a fun thing. So, and you know what really I think is that I think Andy, I know Andy really wants to be friends with me. He wants to make music with me and movies. And honestly, I think that sounds fun because I'm a creative person. I love making shit like that. But what I really think is PPP is holding him back in the sense that he's not allowing him to pursue the creative ventures that he wants to pursue. And ultimately, I think that's going to be an issue between them two because PPP, of course, is, you know, he's funnier, he's more well-spoken. But Andy, I think, is more, you know, into the creative, you know, film and all that stuff. So it's like, if PPP is constantly saying, no, Andy, you know, you can't work with this guy, can't work with that guy, you know, and constantly doing this moral fagging, it's like, I feel like that's going to be a point of contention probably down the road, you know?
Well, I feel the same way. And if you notice on Twitter, now Worski's retweeted a few things, tweeted out some shit, but he hasn't retweeted Fat Ass this whole time. Well, once. Okay, once. And so one time out of this whole time he's retweeted him, and he's just letting him, like, wither out on the vine. And
yeah,
PPP has tweeted, like, I don't even know, 20 times maybe about all this.
Right.
Worski's kind of giving him the bare minimum support, right?
Oh, well, he's absolutely spurging. If you look at his timeline, he's pinned the tweet about PowerChat. He's retweeting his own tweets, you know, totally not mad, totally not tilted, totally not desperate. But yeah, I mean, I see Andy as, you know, a more laid back guy because, you know, I used to really like Andy. We used to be friends. I know you guys basically lived together for a bit. And it's like, I don't know. When he said, hey, let's make some parody songs, I thought, like, fuck yeah, that sounds hilarious. Like, I thought that really sounded fun. So it's like, I don't know. I guess it's like, you know, Andy used to own Worski Live. He used to have this huge platform, but now he has to cater to this fat guy that, like, can tell him what he can do, what he can't do, and all that. And check this out. Also, to Andy's credit, like, when I was calling out the truth, PPP was, like, ripping me apart, and Andy cut him off. He's like, oh, I gotta say, this is based. This is based right here. And PPP's like, no, Andy, like, you know, and just, you can tell PPP doesn't respect Worski. He doesn't respect his opinion. He doesn't allow him to, you know, take these creative ventures and have the networking that Andy should be doing to, you know, get into more mainstream circles and all that. So I don't know, man. I don't know if their partnership's going to work forever. I think they've made a great show for, you know, a couple years here and there. But the sad thing is they end up ruining, like, you know, they're dunking on Nick and it's funny. And then they just ruin it with their petty squabbles because their egos are too big and they just care about the wrong things. And, you know, they brag that they're grifting and, you know, I don't know, man. I just, like, there could have been a different future for where the show went. They could have, you know, pursued the truth, united with some of the people that were doing the same thing. And that would have made fun for everybody. And like you said, they have a scarcity mindset, but they need to have an abundance mindset because there is way more than enough to go around in this sector. You better believe it. And in fact, I think if we were all engaging with each other, everybody would just be so much more hyped up. We would be bringing in more fan bases, more people. And it would just be better all around.
See, Bake gets it. Because he was around during the era when everybody was interacting with each other. And it was way more explosive. Now, sometimes people would fight, of course. But, like, when it was more of, hey, anybody could pop up on anybody's show. And it's a more of a united front against whatever the topic was or whatever was going on versus, and I've really tried to get away from this the last month with this, you know, siloing yourself off and siloing your show off. People really are tired of that. There's been years and years of that, Baked. It's like, it's over.
Yeah.
Let's open shit back up. And
absolutely.
See, I can just hear it, your voice and what you said. You get it.
Yeah. Yeah, no, and you get it too, 100%, Ralph. Here's the thing. It's that we're in a new paradigm with media because the great thing is, yes, like you said, it used to be more open. We siloed off because of all the censorship. But now that things are opening back up, you got Kick, Rumble, Odyssey, et cetera, PowerChat, you know, all sorts of services. If you don't like one, you can use the other. There's a ton of alt tag Gab even, you know? So it's like now, you know, there are options for people. There are, you know, now we can reconnect with everyone. So it's like, yeah, if you're shutting yourself off from everyone, it's just, it's not exciting. It's not, you know, it's not innovative. You're not. And you know what it reminds me of is this is Nick's method. Nick,
right.
Nick Fuentes is the one who siloed himself off on Cozy, and he's banning all his friends and, you know, starting fires with anyone who said, you know, question anything. And look at where his growth is. I mean, you know, Cozy can barely break 120 viewers unless Nick is live. You know, it's really fucking bad. So it's like, you got to ask yourself this question. Why is the casino acting like Nick Fuentes when we have, you know, Elon Musk bought Twitter, we got Twitter Spaces, we got like all these crazy collabs, Foozies out there, these old stars are coming back to IRL and, you know, Kick, Aiden Ross, like there's so much cool things happening. And if we started, you know, cross promoting, you know, like I think here, I'll say this and you might be down. Like, I still think we should do like a softball tournament.
Me too.
Have them come out. They have a team. We have a team. You know, we can dunk on each other a little bit, but at the end of the day, that's going to be better for both fan bases. It's going to attract more people. And it's just like, they're so stuck being like bitter. They're so bitter, dude. They're bitter. They're mad. They're salty. It's like, bro, okay, we get it. You're hipsters. Yes, you saw this before we did, but guess what? We've given you credit where credit is due, and we're trying to help this, you know, alongside this mission. So don't be fucking salty. Are you women? Like, are you on your fucking periods? Like, what the fuck is going on? Y'all some bitches right now. What the fuck? Come on.
I couldn't agree more. And, you know, with what we're saying, people in chat are just like, you know, Ralph's right. Bake gets it. It's boring, Grugman says, which is the key. Yes! Yeah! It's boring. Like, we've been doing this for years. And, you know, it took a lot to get me there, but it's like, okay, let's go back to the old ways. Let's go back to the old ways. You never know who might pop up. Maybe they pop up to argue. Who cares? Like, let's go back to the old days when anything could really happen, right? And people are thirsty for that. And in the cozy lockdowns, I see in chat, right? Like, I mean, there's a huge thirst for this. And people who were around then remember how cool it used to be. And, you know, I take my fair share of the blame for siloing off a bit myself. But, you know, like, that era is over for me. I'm trying to pop on streams. I'm trying to have more people pop on here. And, you know, I don't know. I guess they just don't want to see it, really.
Well, yeah, and I want to bring this up. I agree with you, but it's like, you know, what did we really do to them also? Like, you know, I know, once again, yes, I've thrown some barbs their way. They've certainly thrown some at us. But it's like, I mean, if you actually press them about like, oh, why don't you like Baked? PBB will be like, oh, because he's a federal agent, which has been debunked, not true. Oh, but he's a PowerChat is... you know, run by feds. No, it's not. It's run by Nick. No, it's not. And then he's like, and he abused that girl, Sammy. No, I didn't. I actually gave her $1,000 for rent when she was about to go homeless. I'm still friends with her to this day. She loves me. We're great friends. I was like a huge inspiration in her life. Like, imagine you can't pay your rent. A guy comes around. Oh no, you got to listen to some fart noises on the speaker. Oh no, but you get $1,000 cash tax free. I was really abusing her, wasn't I? So it's like they're living in this delusion just because, I mean, Worski was really jealous during those days. He was seething on the subculture show or whatever with like 50 viewers on DLive when I was getting like 5,000, 8,000, 10,000. Remember that? DLive, YouTube. I had, dude. Some of those Sammy streams, I was making 8K a day cash. Like, I'm not joking. Like,
shit.
That it was fucking nuts. Like, I couldn't, it was not, I had to raise the media to $25 and it was just nonstop. Ding, 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 ding. You know, so it's like, you know, with that being said, though, it's like everyone, even IP2, now IP2 is one of the, like, the most malicious fan bases. Even IP2 agrees, like, oh yeah, this was Bake's best content. Like, you know, Sammy's awesome. Like, their relationship is awesome. So, you know, the point is they're just looking for reasons to like hate us because they're bitter. Because like you said, they're trying to, you know, they have the scarcity mindset. They're trying to protect the table scraps or whatever that they think is out there. But, you know, we're actually, dude, we're having fun. Like what me and Ralph are doing right now, guys, everyone listening, you can't fucking fake this, because me and Ralph text each other and we're just laughing our asses out. We're like, oh my gosh, this is so good. Like, and that's how it should be. And so we're really calling for a content renaissance. Open the floodgates, stop the fucking egos, stop the petty squabbles, stop your pride. Let's go after the fucking pedophiles and let's have some fucking fun.
I couldn't agree more. And even after everything I said today, I'm still willing to put it all to the side. And like you said, really, they did more to us than we ever did to them in the first place. Look, but whatever. Like, I did do some things. Yeah, like, I'm not going to say I didn't do anything. But it's like, you know what? All that shit doesn't really matter in comparison to what we're trying to do now in terms of taking down AF and opening up these shows and bringing good content to the people. And they're like standing in the way. PPB's 800-pound frame, like standing there. No, you can't. Well, no, you can't. Oh, yes, I can, fat motherfucker. Watch me. But it's annoying. Yeah, go ahead. You're going to say something.
Well, I just want to say, like, okay, real nigga alert. Like, can we be real ass niggas and stop this fucking high school shit? Like, you spread your asshole on the internet live. You told somebody to shoot somebody.
Just get this one subscription on Kick.
Like, you guys are acting like your shit doesn't stink. We've all made mistakes, bro. We've all done stupid shit. Stop moralizing every single fucking thing. Listen, pedophiles, yes, destroy them. Lock them up and let's unite. But it's like, are you really going to moralize every single fucking thing everyone's done on stream? When you're a full-time streamer in this sector, you're going to do stupid shit. Believe me, me and Ralph know this very well.
We
you know, so it's like, I just got to say that. It's like, they think they're on such a high horse, but it's like, not that long ago, like, Worski was doing some really fucked up shit. So was PPP. I mean, in fact, they still are today. Last night, PPP was like, oh, look at this Blade guy. I hope he, can people just donate so he just fucking kills himself already? It's like, oh, that's not very nice, you know? So it's like, I just want to say, these guys aren't angels over there. So if they could just lower their pride a little bit, you know, put some stuff aside. You don't have to love everything we do. We don't have to love everything you do. But if we could come together, destroy the pedophiles, and make some funny content, I say, fuck it, let's do it.
I couldn't agree more, and I feel like me and you are on the same wavelength. Now, I got you for about 5 more minutes. I just said I'd keep you for 30. I know you're about to do the camping.
Yeah.
But I saw Slog over in the old chat, and he says, why not answer their questions so this can end? No questions answered. We did go through every single question.
I already answered.
That's what I'm saying. Like. And by the way, Slog, if you're listening, give me a question right now, because I literally went through the questions and what exactly has not been answered. Now, you still don't have to like PowerChat. Like, that's fair if you don't want to like it. But like, I don't feel like we skipped any questions on PowerChat.
Well, let me just say for the record, Nick Fuentes owns 0% of PowerChat. 0, 0, 0, 0, none. He is not on the board. He is not an advisor. He is not on some secret panel with some secret contract. Nick has nothing. You really think I would be blasting Nick like this daily if he was on the board of PowerChat? That makes no sense.
Well, Bates, he literally tried to say you killed somebody a couple weeks ago.
Yeah. Nick has nothing to do with PowerChat. Groypers have nothing to do with PowerChat. You know, did some cozy adjacent people work with us like a year ago? Yeah, of course things were different then, but things are different now. But at the end of the day, they're spurging over something that's really not that big of a deal. If you don't like PowerChat, you don't have to use it. We've always kept the data safe of our users. Even when people hacked Ralph's account, you still couldn't dox the users. All that information comes from the payment processors, and it always has, no matter if you use Streamlabs or Stream Elements or whatever the fuck. So any streamer has access to that information, not on PowerChat, but on the payment processors, PayPal, Stripe, you know, you name it. So it's like, they're literally making an issue up out of their ass. Hey, if you don't like it, nobody's forcing you to use it. The people that like it, guess what? They love it. Everyone tells me how much they love PowerChat. They love the different voices. They love how it works, how it's simple, it's easy. It just works. And like you were saying with LOULZ, which was a great interview, by the way.
Thank you.
Is, we created PowerChat because we didn't have anything. We were getting banned from Streamlabs, from everything. And we just made it for ourselves. And you know how it grew? Because we didn't make it as like a public product at first. The way that it grew was like word of mouth. Like people would be like, oh shit, like, can I get on that? Like Vince James hit us up. Like, hey dude, that looks fucking awesome. Like, how do I get a PowerChat? And we're like, okay, yeah, we can give you one, I guess. And like, you know, and it was just like,
that's how I got on it. Cause it was, I was like, damn, I need to get on this.
Yeah, it was invite only. And then later, we had such a demand that we're like, okay, we'll make it go public. And I'll say this too, like, all our money right now, it goes back to paying our developers. Like, I don't make money off PowerChat. LOULZ doesn't make money off PowerChat. None of us, like, I'm not getting a paycheck, Ralph. We put all 100% of the money right now. You know, maybe it'll change in the future.
And
but
I'm glad you said that because I heard that last night.
Yeah.
And I didn't want to say it unless you said it because it's true. A little too deep.
Yeah. And I mean, once again, this is why it's disingenuous, Ralph. Everybody that uses PowerChat has no issues. They love it. The only people bitching are people that would never use PowerChat in the first place. So just remember that.
Yeah, and I think everything you said there, very fair. And again, I heard that last night I knew it was true from the person I heard it from. And then I was like, I don't want to say that because they told me that. And I was like, really? Are you serious? And I don't think people realize how much money was put into PowerChat itself.
And
there's a reason that it's way better than pretty much every other TTS service because they put a lot of money into it. And all those voices and all the options and crypto options and subs and all this stuff. That shit doesn't come cheap, and shit like Streamlabs and Stream Elements and all these others, well, they got a venture capitalist behind it or somebody with deep pockets, and these are just streamers who wanted to band together, right, create something for other streamers, and, you know, I don't know if people really realize the amount of money that's been put into it, but hopefully they do.
Oh, yeah. Well,
yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, let me say this too real quick. Like, I also realized this when I was eating some Chipotle, very bomb food, by the way. You know, you got to get a burrito bowl now and then.
You got to.
Okay. listen. Oh, wait. Sorry, that reminds me. I really want to come to Mexico and try some of the food there because when you're talking about those tortas, man, I'm I bet those are so bomb.
They are.
Yeah. Sorry, sidetracked. But anyways. Why is it? Let's just ask ourselves, why is it that whenever people on the right wing create something good, like I said, we created this just for ourselves. Like, and I'll say this honestly, Ralph, like anyone who doesn't want to use PowerChat could stop using it today. And I wouldn't fucking care. Like, I don't care. We made it for us. We made it for like streamers that need the tools. That's it. That is absolutely, it's free to use. It's not, like I said, me and LOULZ don't. We're not paying ourselves out every month. We could if we wanted to be greedy, but no, we want to put the money into the development and the servers and make sure it's stable, because if streamers can't make money, then we don't have content, and that sucks. So, and it is a free speech platform. That's why, yeah, there's people we really don't like, but guess what? We're not banning them. We're not banning anybody. The only reason we would ban is if we had to, like, you know, law enforcement's like, hey, you know, someone like broke crazy laws on your platform. That's the only case. And we haven't, you know, that hasn't happened yet. And hopefully we won't have to really, you know, deal with that too much. But I just want to say, it's very strange. Like, why do people on the right wing need to always shoot ourselves in the foot? We got PowerChat. We got New Project 2. We got, and what does everyone want to do? Oh my gosh, it's a scam. They're feds. It's like, Can we make anything good anymore without just trying to sabotage what we're doing? Like, don't we complain about the liberals owning everything, the globalists, you know, running the media and the banks and the tech companies? Okay, well, people like me and LOULZ are trying to help, man. and you're attacking us. You're like, oh, we need to see a list of all your employees. How about go fuck yourself? Like, that doesn't make any sense. That may, like, no, zero companies operate like that. That makes, like, we're not a publicly traded company, dude. We're a private company. If you like our services, use us. Great. We love you. It's awesome. If you don't, that's okay too. We're not mad about it. We don't need every single person on the planet to use it. If you want to use it, great. But I just wanted to say, I want everyone to think about that. Well, why is it that when we are on the right or on the whatever, people continue to sabotage our own guys?
Great points all around. And, you know, their whole talking point about who's so-and-so? What about this guy? And tell us who works here and what's their name and where do they live? I'm like, fuck out of here. Like, you know what? You'd be better sticking to just, I don't like PowerChat because Baked's involved or LOULZ involved or whatever, right?
Yeah.
You know what? You'd be better just sticking to that because that's really the truth. Or I'm trying to fuck with Ralph because he uses it or fuck with whoever because they use it. That would be acceptable. But this whole, who is so-and-so and what about this guy and what does he work for you and what's his name and who is, now, you know what, just fuck out of here. That's like just insane spurgery. And like you said, no company operates that way and you have no obligation to do that. And nobody with any sense in their fucking brain would do that because then who would want to come work with you? Like what the fuck, it doesn't even make any sense.
Right.
So it's retardation all around.
Yeah.
I don't know. Final thoughts on that. And then also your stream tonight, tell people where to find you. I told you I'd only keep you 30 minutes. So
yes. Thank you, Ralph. This has been very fun. Killstream's been on fire. In my opinion, your best work, sober Ralph, best Ralph, not even close. You know, keep killing it, man. I'm really loving it. I love calling in, you know. I would love to see you in Miami next month. I think we should do Killstream Miami.
Should we do it? Miami too?
Yeah, let's fucking do it.
You know, I got
it.
An infamous history with the city of Miami. Should we do Miami too without gay-ass Worski? Yeah, maybe we should.
Let's do Miami too. Yeah, and what we should do is you can do the show from my house, and then during the week, and then during the weekend we'll go around Miami, get some hotels, and you know, have some. I think it'd be perfect. So, get hyped for that, everybody. Get some fucking tickets. You know, look at flights. Text me later. But yeah, man, I just gotta say I'm having so much fucking fun. I know we're doing the right thing. I know God is on our side. I know the truth is on our side, and that's why I say Yoba season 15. God will curse the wicked. That's Proverbs 3:33. And the second part of that verse is, and he will bless the righteous. And listen, we're not perfect people, but look in the Bible. Everybody who God used in the Bible, including Paul, who murdered Christians, they were very broken people that did very awful things. But guess what? God gave them another chance, and he wrote a new chapter in their lives, just like he's doing for us. I fucking love you, Ralph.
Thank
you're
you,
my
brother.
Fucking brother
you
till I die. Ralph Amell till I fucking fucking die, bro. I mean that shit. So thank you so much, Yoba Gang for life. We're gonna be live on LOULZ tonight, kick.com/LOULZ. I love you guys so much. Peace out, and
thank
I'll
you,
see
brother.
You soon.
We love you too, man. Take it easy. I'll talk to you soon.
Take care.
Baked Alaska. See, you know what? That's how you can tell somebody who's genuine about what they're talking about as far as Christianity and uplifting and those who are not. What he just said about the Bible and God using imperfect people was more uplifting and had more just wholesomeness and genuineness than anything PPP has said about the Lord or Christ or the Bible in maybe his whole life, but definitely the last 2 years.
Thank you for watching this clip. This is the CACA Lofa. Remember to like and subscribe.